Daily Dispatch powered by HSBC.
Well, joining us for this very special interview is Mr. Mohit Goyal from Vedic Cosmeceuticals. Thank you very much, Mr. Goyal, for joining us today on the Daily Dispatch. I want to begin by talking about the $25 million fundraise that's recently been completed. Tell us a little bit about what this funding really means for you.
Before we start, I'd like to thank you, Priya, for giving me this opportunity to be here on this show with you. It's been quite some time since we've been in the business of manufacturing skincare, and it's only lately now with the advent of e-commerce and a lot of brands getting funding that we decided to go for a Series A funding. Primary aims there would be to enhance manufacturing capabilities and to look at other acquisitions in the same space.
When you talk about the kind of brands that you're working with, I believe this contract manufacturing space has also led to, seen a huge boom because of the kind of D2C brands that have been entering the space in the pandemic. And I believe you have more than 50 brands that you are working with in terms of manufacturing. So tell us a little bit about, the whole process and what's the kind of growth roadmap that you see out there.
Well, Priya, I'm really fortunate to say that we are associated with a few of the top D2C brands in India. In fact, we've just got news of another good client of ours being acquired by the Good Glam Group. We got that news today morning. So we've practically got about four or five big brands that we've been working with in the past 7-8 years, now being acquired or getting funding, good capitalization for them. I'm really happy that brands have shown faith in us. They've grown with us. We've grown with them. Going ahead, we are spending a lot of focus on research and development. We are focusing a lot on getting the right manpower, getting the right machinery in place, so as to give them quicker turnaround times. We are absolutely sure that we don't want to launch our own labels. Because one, it is a direct conflict of interest to consumers. Secondly, I firmly believe in doing what best one should be doing. So we've been in the business of manufacturing for the past 18, 19 years. We've kind of mastered the art of turning around products quickly, giving them clean beauty products, and that's where we want to be. So I know a lot of questions come in when funding comes in that, would you be launching your own brand? It's a tempting question, but we are absolutely clear that we don't want to go ahead on that route. The money is primarily going to be used for enhancing capabilities, for bettering efficiencies, and for acquisitions in a similar space so that we can give the entire portfolio of products that a customer wants, whether it's color cosmetics, whether it's perfumery-related products, whether it's Ayurvedic products, everything.
You know, when you say that you're looking at expanding into newer spaces at this point in time, what kind of roadmap do you have? One, in terms of expanding your current presence, you'll be setting up new units for manufacturing as well. And secondly, in terms of expanding to different categories via the acquisition route, which are the categories that you're looking at primarily?
Well, we're looking at primarily color cosmetics. We are looking at, as I said, perfumery. So alcohol. Companies in the business of manufacturing body mists or body perfumes, hand sanitizers. That is another segment that we are looking at. We are also launching a new segment, which will be under the name of Vedic Labs, where there will be full-fledged R&D work done for actives, for ingredients, as well as for the final products. Because we believe in presenting newer concepts. We have, we do continuous studies on newer ingredients, newer concepts that can be presented to clients. So we try and understand what the client needs. We try and preempt what the client could need, and we try and work towards that. So Vedic as such is not a plain vanilla manufacturer. So we are not a manufacturer where a client comes to us, tells us, I want this, and we give you that. We try and understand from the client. We get a brief on what they are doing, what is their vision, what is the brand vision. And then we try and create products which can map their vision and give them a deliverable that works that way.
You know, I want to understand some key metrics from you, Ms. Goyal, in terms of what are the number of products that you perhaps manufacture in a day. It will be interesting for our audience to know what's the kind of capacity that you have at this point in time, and any metrics in terms of how you'd like to grow this. What is the kind of number that you're targeting, maybe 6 to 8 months down the line?
So Priya, we are a little different from a regular FMCG contract manufacturer. A regular FMCG contract manufacturer would possibly be doing 3 to 5 products in a day, continuous processes, maybe even 3 to 5 products in a month on a continuous basis. The difference between them and us is that we probably do a turnaround of maybe 20 to 25 products a day with packs, with the quantities of finished products ranging from 2,500 pieces to 25,000 pieces. So while we may be doing, say, 2 lakh units a day, it'll probably be spread over 20 different products where we have to go for changeovers in between, which is a tedious process. But over the years, we've geared up to be able to cater to that sort of a demand. We know when startups come to us, their quantities are not much. They will go with, say, 2,500, 3,000 pieces. And our entire setup has been geared up, has been made or designed in a manner where we can do quick changeovers. We can quickly pack products from 2,500 pieces to, say, 25,000 pieces, as I said, and give them the delivery basis, the requirement that they've put forward. When they go to a large-scale FMCG manufacturer, this sort of a setup, their setups don't permit them to do that. So our manufacturing machineries are geared up accordingly. Our packaging lines are geared up accordingly. Our staff, so to say, is geared up accordingly because they know that these are the changeovers that will happen. It's a very, very tedious process, but I would say that, yes, it's a different segment. And we've kind of, over the years, we've kind of learned how to deal with this sort of a trickiness.
Right. The final question before I let you go on revenue and growth targets, are there any numbers that you can share at the end of FY22 and maybe a 2025 target that if you have any?
Ambitious 5x in the next 3 to 4 years, 10x in the next 5 years, good growth plans. And hopefully if all goes well, if everything is as per the plans, maybe look at an IPO 5 to 6 years down the line.
And at the end of FY22, what kind of revenue will you close the year at?
Well, FY22, that's March next year. I think anywhere between 60 to 70 CR is what we're targeting.
And, all right. And ambitious growth path going forward, the 5X and 10X kind of growth.
I think it's very much possible looking at the kind of funding that the brands are getting, looking at the market. So it's about $130 billion market in 2020, and it's envisaged to go up to $200 billion. So we all know the kind of growth that this sector is seeing, and there's tremendous scope with people now wanting to go with cleaner beauty products, and that's where Vedic steps in. So as I said, our system is geared up to enable startups to come to us with an idea and then reach the shelf. So that's, and we all know the kind of startups that are coming into this space because it's a booming industry. And if we can get to that, then it's good for everybody.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Goyal. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you, Priya. It was a pleasure to be here.